Hey, Sean Jantz here, and I'm doing a quick mental plan for Thursday, May 2nd, and I'm going to do it on /ES, which is the S&P 500 and the other indices that you can find on NADEX. And I'm going to start here on /ES, and if you watched the previous night's trade plan, you knew that we gone into brand new all-time highs, 29.61 and a quarter. We had Apple earnings at the close of Tuesday, which kind of pushed us higher, right? And I was a little disappointed because I've been waiting and waiting for a pretty decent sell-off. Now, we actually did get a pretty good cycle today. But we had a federal funds rate. They're not raising rates, but quite a few people sold off once that Fed funds rate came out. And for the first time in an entire month, this chart cycled back down into the daily middle blue Keltner. So now it wasn't, when you look at this in the bigger picture, it wasn't huge by any means. In my opinion, this still has plenty of room to continue cycling. And you can see how, right? You can see that we've pretty much just kind of moved back in here to middle blue Keltner. Lots of room to continue cycling. We go to the 4-hour chart. You can kind of see that pretty quick cycle down. You can see, 2,900 would be kind of the big target for these bears tomorrow if they continue. And honestly, 2,900 is kind of where I'd want to be looking for my support tomorrow. Who knows if we'll make it, but if these bears continue, that's where I'd want to be looking for my support. And it's important to understand all of the cycles. So if you go to the 30-minute chart cycle, you'll notice that we're now starting to get, we're starting to get oversold. So we may see a little push back higher. So there could be a retrace. 2940 would be kind of that decent retrace level. And then if we go any higher, that's where, 50 or higher is where I'd want to be looking for my retrace sell triggers. You can kind of quickly do a little Fibonacci move here. 40s, 50. It's the 50%, there's your 61.8, right? So lots of people on these measured moves. I only draw Fibonacci's on measured move. I would consider that's a 40 points within 24 hours. That's a measured move, right? So you can draw that Fibonacci there. So the reason Fibonacci works is because so many people draw it and they make it happen. So everybody else and their dog is seeing these exact same levels I'm seeing. So if a lot of bulls get after it tomorrow and this 30-minute chart cycles back up, this is going to be the targets and possible resistance as well, okay? And so now that we built that story, we move to the 15-day, 15-minute plot chart. No more indicators, and what I'm looking for here is I'm just looking for structure. I'm looking for the best places to buy, the best places to sell. I'm looking for support, resistance, supply, and demand zones. And what I always do is I start exactly where price is, and then I start planning and visualizing. What am I going to do or not do at every single zone if we cycle higher? And then what am I going to do or not do if we continue lower? So let's first talk about if we go higher. We already kind of talked about, based off of that 30-minute chart, we might see a cycle. And I wouldn't buy just yet because we're kind of, you notice how we're kind of in what I consider a confliction zone. We have lots of room to continue cycling down to 2,900, but then we're oversold on the 30-minute and the 1-hour chart. So we're pretty much there's literally, just obviously my subjective opinion. There's literally nothing to do where price currently is. We're literally smack dab in the middle. Here's our 15-day high. Here's our 15-day low. We're in the middle, right? And so what I would want to do is I'd want to wait for some strength before I consider doing anything. Because here's a pretty good bull target. Right back in the value rate low and that plus 0.5. You can even use this 2POC cluster as a bull target as well. So if that 30-minute chart starts cycling, that's likely where it's going to want to go. But I wouldn't buy just yet. I would wait for set as a breakout and then find your higher lows on that 1-minute chart. So breakout, higher lows, and then we can continue riding the strength, right? Right now, they're not really showing us strength yet. So we want to see strength first, and then we can ride the strength, okay? If you don't see a higher low, I get it. It sucks. Sometimes there isn't one, and sometimes you just can't enter. And then, of course, I'm not against using that for first sell trigger. The catch is, though, is that this would need to be a really quick, Like, if I were going to sell here, it needs to be get in there and really, really quick sell trade. Because this does have plenty of room to cycle back up into this supply zone. And so if I would need to make sure I'm seeing some good content, good context, some decent change control before I sell there. And if I were to say what's my favorite place to sell, it's very obvious. It's right there, right? It's beautiful. Retrace back up into that all-time high supply, plus one, Thursday POC, value area high. That's where I'd want to be looking for my big sell triggers. Who knows if we'll make it, but that's where I'm salivating, right there, okay? Now if we continue to go lower, first contact zone is negative and a half. I personally don't really like that for anything. You look left, there's really nothing there. You know, when I look at this, we have kind of the big round number, 2,900 and a negative one. Right into this is where I'd want to be looking, because if we do go lower, then we're going to be pretty severely oversold. And there's actually decent demand to the left. We got a negative one deviation, 2,900. So I'd want to get into there. Now, here's also a key. These bears obviously showed some teeth, okay? And so if I'm going to buy anything tomorrow, I got to make sure that I'm quick, I'm nimble, and I got to make sure I'm entering on high or low change control. Because if this chart by some one of the, we saw a negative one today, and we may see a continued negative one. So you got to, or even greater than negative one, right? Because bulls always take the stairs. Bears take the, look, they took the elevator today, and they can, we can continue seeing elevators based off of the weekly chart and the daily chart. Notice how I've been kind of really talking about this for 2 to 3 weeks. Like, we are going to like we dumped going into the close. We can continue to see more dumps. So like, even if you buy here and it continues to go lower on you, don't be crying, because that's just the big picture continuing to cycle lower. That's why you got to be nimble, you got to be quick, take profits, and you got to make sure you're buying on change control, because you don't want to get ran over. And I don't want to say this is the tough thing, because it's also a good thing if you know what you're doing, but volatility picks up. Volatility just jumped quite a bit. And so if you go to the VIX, based off of today, the VIX just jumped 13% today. So what this means is the higher this chart goes, the more movement we're going to see, the faster movement we're going to see. So first, if you're new, right, when the VIX goes higher, you're going to see faster movement. And when you're new, that can probably scare you. If you know what you're doing, it's freaking awesome. Okay, so we want this VIX to go as high as possible, because when you're experienced, that's how you can make profit literally within minutes. And we're not talking small profit here, within minutes. Because the higher volatility goes, the more faster, quicker movement we see in the market. If you're inexperienced, the higher VIX can really screw you over. But how do you gain experience? Trading the market. Just get in there. If when in doubt, stay out, or just demo your ass off so you can start understanding how VIX pops work. Okay. Quickly moving on here, slash and Q, it's very similar. I'm going to go through this quick. You know, get through set, hold higher lows. There's the bull target. And I'm not looking for resistance there. I don't like that. If I were to look for, look at that context. Holy crap. Tuesday, Thursday, Friday, a plus one deviation. I mean, holy crap, right? I mean, that's, I don't know if we'll make it there, but if we do, I'm salivating right there for sell triggers. The lower we go, you know, you do got a negative 0.5. It's not terrible, but honestly, if I were to buy, I'd want to be down into here and even here, okay? And then you got slash YM, pretty much the same as in Q. Get through set, hold higher lows. There's your first target on that plus 0.5. I'm not looking for resistance there. Not in the middle. I would need to be up into there. And as far as demand, this isn't terrible, actually. It actually has some pretty good, decent content context. My favorite demand, though, is down into that negative one. And then slash RTY. Very similar to actually ES as far as to the upside. You can see plus 0.5 and value area low are right on top of each other. And so breakout, hold higher lows, there's the target. If you were to sell there, make it crazy quick, but my favorite sell trigger zone is going to be right there. And then you got first demand and second. So message me if you have any questions. Take pictures of all of your trades. And if we continue to see massive dumps, don't get ran over, okay? Understand what's going on in the big picture, and that'll always help you. And as always, if we do start seeing dumps, which I honestly hope we do, we want even more dumps because we need to release some more. We had a good release of bull pressure today. We need more, okay? And so if we do see a bigger release of bull pressure, don't get ran over, and when in doubt, stay out, okay? And that's another reason why it's nice to have binaries, because the max loss is built into the contract, and so there's no need to stop loss, and so those can provide some pretty good opportunities. If you can't control your emotions, just let the binary contract control the emotion for you. So message me if you have any questions. Take pictures of all of your trades and post them in the group and in the chat room so that you can get feedback from me and from others.